passing point this morning. It's September 14th, 13th. I'll show you in a minute here, but it's really, really hazy. Again, Montana, this is one of Montana's worst fire seasons. Some of the driest on record for Montana. So mountains have been closed off to morning hunts only. So we started our day at 3:30 this morning, got ready, parked down below at the road, and hiked up. For 50 years old, I barely made it up the hill, but we're up here now. We're classing elk in every direction, some small bulls, just waiting for
I'm 43 and I've been through 5 knee surgeries.
That's no excuse.
Yeah.
At 50 years old, I'm still making it up this damn mountain. Cameron Haynes ain't got shit on me. Hey, just kidding. Okay, so we got two bowmen. Bubby Gopher. Say hi, Bubs. And we got his dad, Keith Gopher. Say hi, Keith.
Good morning.
Okay. So we got a couple bulls out in some different directions, but I want to show you how hazy it is. It's really, really hazy all over here. Several fires in the region around Rocky Boy, different reservations, browning, haze. But we're catching all the smoke here. So I'm gonna zoom into where these boys got some elk spotted, looking through their spotting scopes here. Let's see if I can get on. Might be just a bit too hazy for my camera to pick up anything.
We had seen numerous elk every day. We was up in the field, we had seen elk. It was just a joy to be out there. Even though we had countless elk in our optics, that doesn't get you within killing range with a bow. Everything has to come together for bow hunting to happen. As you'll see with this first setup. We had our ambush site selected, we had our shooter in place. Keith started throwing some calls, and we had this bull coming in on a string.
This particular bull we spotted miles away through our spotting scopes. We saw that he was a good 6 and something that we wanted to pursue. There isn't anything more heart pumping than having a bull like this coming into bow range. At this point, I need to take my time and catch my breathing, and hopefully let all the preparation take its course. On this particular hunt, I end up missing this bull, which kind of put me in a bad place. I didn't I worked so hard during the months before that to get one opportunity, and I just blew it. We had everybody in line, everything worked out the way it was supposed to, but there's just sometimes as an archery hunter, you got to deal with the lows and the highs. And my first reaction when I missed this bull was, I don't know, just defeat. I trained hard just to get that one opportunity and just didn't work out for me, and it was just defeat all the way around.
Just come to listen, that's all we did. And we got here, I went to use the bathroom. You heard him bugle, he's still here. So we just 6:30, the rocks were gonna be ready, so we just left, pulled out. That next day, which was I think Thursday, it was just way too bad. The weather was ugly, really ugly.
Rainy, windy.
Yeah, so we didn't even come up. Then the day it lifted, Friday, was it? Yeah, Friday we came up, and then that's when we seen this guy take over that 8x8, and we're sitting in the truck. That 8x8 come walking about 60 yards from the truck, and we're just sitting in there. We didn't even get out to go glass it. So that's kind of how that all happened. So we knew that 8x8 was in here, which he's probably in here somewhere yet. And we knew this bull was in here, and we got on him yesterday. We were up there, and their elk were here. And Bubby took off running off this mountain. He went around this way, hooked around, he got in front of him. And the elk just basically went the wrong way. I mean, they could have came towards him just as easy. They were about 100 yards from him, and there's nothing he could do. And there were about 30 head of cows, this guy, and several other bulls. And they dove into here. And then, of course, yesterday we come up here, and you guys went down in here and seen all the other elk, but didn't see this guy, so...
You heard him though, and
I didn't really know. I just didn't know. I mean, I didn't know. I mean, I couldn't figure out where he was at or what they were doing. And this morning we got out of the truck, we got up there, and as soon as I got to the top, I spotted that cow on this ridge. And just 10 seconds after that, I seen this guy come up, and he chased her down. So we just kind of come running on the hill and got down best we can, and it worked out.
We had, about a week ago, we had a different herd bull with that herd. But was it 8x8? He got kicked out by this bull we just got done shooting. So the 8x8's still around here somewhere. He's like looking for cows now, and he got kicked out of his herd. Pretty pumped. Been watching this bull for about, what is it, 2 days now?
shot was 493, 453, and then the last shot right here was 444.
These bulls for about a week and a half, 2 weeks, and now we're just waiting for rifle season, which opened here in this past few hours. We just got up to this glassing point and we saw this big herd bull and his cows, so we just took off after down here and made a 400 yard shot.
Being out in the backcountry in God's creation, it definitely takes a toll on you. We've been out there for 20 plus days straight, morning and evening, just hammering away at the mountains, doing what we love. It takes a toll on you, but to experience success is, bar none, the greatest feeling in the world. I wouldn't trade it for anything. Pair of months in advance, trying to get ready for that opportunity. We do months of preparation. We go out scout just about every day of the summer. We lift weights just for one thing in mind, and that's success. This particular hunt was something special for me because it was the biggest bull I ever got to date. To have it all come together the way it did for us, with doing it with my dad, Jason, and the HTR crew, made it that much sweeter for me.